Hello everyone, it's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with this week's edition of Protect Your Portfolio. In this weekly presentation, we take a longer-term look at the North American markets using weekly charts. Of course, we use weekly charts to help filter out all of that market noise from Monday to Friday, so we're left with just one decision point, and that, of course, is the closing price from 4 p.m. Friday afternoon. Well, it's Sunday night and the futures have opened. They've been trading for a couple of hours. Dow futures currently down just under 200 points. We still have more than 12 hours to go before the market opens on Monday morning. So there is a little bit of a negative bias, but at least it tells us there were no major disasters or kerfuffles over the weekend. Now, we just finished the month of May, and of course, the end of the month usually has a bullish bias to it. But what happened to the old saying, sell in May and go away? Certainly, investors did not do that this May. Inside week last week for the VIX, at that time, we were looking for a close above 46.97. That didn't happen, and now we move a week ahead. The upper trend line has continued to move lower with the VIX itself, which was down a little over 2%. So we're going to remain long-term bullish on the market as long as the VIX does not close above 44.56 this coming Friday. Now, when we look at the long-term chart of the VIX, you can see we're still above $25. Notice that in 2019, we were down near the 1250 level most of the year. So we are still very elevated. So there is a lot of people concerned, a lot of people willing to pay premiums to buy those options to cover or to hedge against downward pressure on their portfolios. So those prices are still elevated. That tells me that a lot of people are still concerned. And of course, $25 looks like a potential area of support. It was resistance back here. It could certainly act as support and be the catalyst for a move higher in the not so distant future. If you're watching the markets during the week, we're starting off Monday looking for the VIX to close above 31.23 to give us a buy signal. That, of course, would be negative for stocks on a short-term basis. And of course, that upper trend line is going to continue to move lower daily if we do not close above it on Monday. Looking at the S&P 500, we were up over 3% on the week, heading towards 312.50. We closed above the $300 level, so that is certainly no longer a potential area of resistance. There's the NASDAQ heading up towards the highs from earlier in the year. Our next mathematical target is 237.50. There's the iShares for the TSX 60 moving up on the week. Our next target to the upside is 23.44. And just above that is the top of the open gap. Now, last week I talked about the fact the market really didn't care about moon cycles and seasonalities. So far, because the coronavirus, the pandemic is overwhelming how people are looking at the market. If we look at the seasonalities of the month of June, I just wanted to point out that we often get a summer high and a summer low in the month of June. So I'm expecting volatility to expand. Not sure the direction, but I'm expecting volatility to expand in the month of June. Now, looking at what's working, well, bank stocks were up nicely on both sides of the border, but in neither case could we make a new weekly buy signal. We're looking at biotech stocks, still doing very well. We're looking at technology stocks, semiconductors still doing well. They're leading the market higher. What's not working? Well, anything to do with the energy sector. There's the SPDR ETF for the energy sector. There's oil and gas equipment. There's oil and gas exploration not doing well. We've got metals and mining not doing well at the moment. That, of course, is if you take away gold, what you're left with isn't doing well. Gold stock's still doing very well. There's retail moving up into the channel. Now, notice in 2019, retail could not break out above the flypaper channel. We've had quite a rush up into the channel from the lows that we've made. And that might have to do with the number of bankruptcies that are happening in the retail sector. The companies that are left have less competition, so that could be good for them going forward. Now, gold stocks have done very well over the past month or so. They were down on the week on both sides of the border. And certainly this is the time and place where you would look to lock in some profits if you have not already done so. We're coming off an overbought condition, you can see here. And if we look at the panic zone chart, you can see a new early warning signal up there at the top of the screen. So this is the time and place where investors may take money off the table and see a pullback. in the price of gold stocks. You know, here's a little a big area of congestion back here down at the $16 level, and we could certainly move back down to there without doing a lot of long-term damage. I have no expectations that we're going to go down to the lows that we saw a few months ago, which are back in the lows of last year. I think we could just make it back down towards the $16 level, looking at the iShares for the TSX Gold Index. Let's finish off looking at commodities and an inside week for the price of crude oil. We saw gasoline move slightly higher. No joy for natural gas, making a new low for this move. Then we see the GLD move down just 30 cents on the week after dipping into the channel. Then we're looking at palladium. Palladium had a small pullback. Platinum moved slightly higher inside week for platinum. And the price of silver moved up on the week, heading towards those highs from earlier in the year. Okay, folks, that is all for this weekend's presentation. No surprises. The end of the month had a bullish bias to it. That's what we would expect. No major damage done so far. And we are expecting volatility to start to expand in the month of June. Have a great day, folks. And the next time you'll hear my voice is on Tuesday morning. And at that time, we'll take a look at the North American markets.